Very good evening to all of you. I'm extremely sorry for the technical glitch that happened and it delayed the session by some 8 minutes. So my apologies to you for that. My name is Karishma and I bring to you the series of Improve Your Reading Comprehension. And I am a VARC educator at An Academy Plus. Could somebody quickly please confirm if I'm audible and visible right now? Yes. All right. I think there is a lag. I mean, usually there is a 15-second lag. It looks a little bigger today. Okay, so then, if I'm audible and visible, then I'll start. Meri kundli mein likha hua hai ki technical glitches hote rahenge. But anyway, so I was telling you that we aim to do genres of various passages of various genres in this series, and we're going to cover as much variety as possible. So we are picking up all the difficult genres, and as always, you're welcome to comment a link of an article that you want me to cover in this series. Today I have made a little change in what we usually do, and I have some questions for you which are based on the passage that we are going to discuss, and also the passage is super interesting and something that I had never heard of earlier. So let's dive into it without any delay. In the early 2000s, I encountered a patient who had lost his previously active mind's eye, okay? Man ki aankhe. We are not talking about teesra netra and stuff. We are talking about the mind's eye. Mind's eye means your imagination, your visualization, okay? So there was this guy, the author encountered this guy who had lost his mind's eye, okay? Following neural complications, so there were complications in his nervous system arising from a heart surgery. So heart surgery hui, usse kuch nervous system mein there were complications, and then finally he lost his power to see shapes in his mind. He could no longer conjure up. I'm sure you've watched the movie The Conjuring, okay? So conjure up is to bring forth, okay? Aavahan karna, jaga dena, usually ghosts and stuff. The faces of family and friends. So imagine if I want to think about, let's say, my grandfather who is no more and I can't think of his face right now, then how will I remember him? So this is the problem that's happening with him. He cannot recall faces of his family or friends, visualize places he had visited, and imagine scenes in a novel. Imagine reading a novel without being able to not imagine, okay? Even his dreams were now without imagery. I can't imagine having a dream without any imagery. Before his loss, the vividness means the liveliness, V-I-V means life, that's a root word, okay, of his imagery approached real seeing. Afterwards, he saw nothing in his mind. Please remember, we are talking about seeing here in our minds. For example, let's do an experiment. Let's close our eyes and think about a rose, okay, gulab, okay. Can you imagine a rose in your mind? Is it red? Is it white? Yellow? Pink? Black? Okay. Does it have thorns? Do you see leaves in your mind? So this is known as imagination or visualization. This is what is lacking in this patient. Though he could still think perfectly well about objects and concepts. So this guy was able to think about a rose or a concept maybe, but then he cannot see it in his mind. And he functioned very fine in everyday life. I was intrigued. Intrigued is your interest was piqued, okay? You were curious. Visualization is, for most of us, such a central ingredient of our mental lives. At work, in memory, jab sochte hain tab, reverie is daydreaming, aap log ka hobby, yes, aap log kho jate hain kahin. Dreaming, reading, problem solving, creativity. Think of an apple for a moment, was it green or red? Shiny or gnarled? Gnarled is crooked, twisted. Okay, was there a stalk? Stalk is apple ki dandi, okay, this is the stalk. Could you have used the stalk to twirl the apple on request? So if I asked you to twirl it, can you do it? If you can answer these questions, or at least if they make sense to you, it is likely that you experience visual imagery as most of us do. It means you behave like most people behave and you are able to think in visuals. Given his deficit, it seemed remarkable that our patient MX, as we called him, was able to function so well. तो सुनने में ये कितनी बड़ी कमी लगती है, दिट साउंड्स लाइक अ ग्रेट डील, ओके, बट दिस गाय वॉज एबल टू फंक्शन नॉर्मली. इन फैक्ट एमएक्स वॉज एन आइडियल रिसर्च पार्टिसिपेंट. वाई? बिकॉज ही वॉज इंटेलिजेंट, ही वॉज इंटरेस्टेड, एंड ही वॉज कॉग्निटिवली इंटैक्ट. कॉग्निटिव, आई हैव टॉट यू दिस वर्ड रिपीटेडली, COGN मीन्स नॉलेज. COGN, SCI, साइंस, रिकोगनाइज का COGN, एंड GNOS, एग्नोस्टिक, प्रोग्नोस्टिक, डायग्नोसिस, all of these roots stand for knowing or knowledge. So he was absolutely intact in all respects, bar this single subtle but striking deficit. What does bar mean here? Not the bar where you go and say, may I offer you a drink? Okay, so this bar means except. Barring, jise hum kehte hain. Barring my 10th standard exams, I have excelled in academics, which means except my 10th standard, I was good at academics. But anyway, so this single, subtle and striking deficit. So striking to tha, badi kami hai, single tha, ek hi kami hai, aur subtle hai, kyunki dikhti nahi hai. Using functional MRI scanning, I have taught you, this is also published as fMRI in various RC passages. Now, if you find it, you are not going to behave, I don't know, okay? We show that while his neural activity was normal when he looked at famous faces, once he tried to visualize them mentally, he failed to engage the visual parts of his brain as you or I would if we engaged our mind's eye. His presentation matched a disorder of visual imagery generation, previously described by the American psychologist Martha, drawing on the background work of another psychologist, Stephen. I found MX's case fascinating and odd, but unlikely to lead much further. Then events, as they sometimes do, took an unexpected turn. So basically he's saying that, you know, this was a normal guy and his neural activity was normal if you look at famous faces. And, you know, once he tried to visualize them, then there was a difference because our brains look different from what his brain looked like. So this work has been done earlier by these scientists. The names are mentioned here. They're not very important in the overall context of the passage. In 2010, the US scientist, journalist Carl Zimmer described our work on MX's case in the Science magazine Discovery. So pura jo case study author kar raha tha, ye Discover naam ke magazine mein chapa. Over the next few years, 21 people contacted me, explaining that they had recognized themselves in Zimmer's lucid description of MX, which means 21 people called the author and his team that we are of the same category. We can't imagine images, okay? We can't think in images. We can't see objects with our eyes closed. Lucid is clear. I have taught this to you. L-U-C means clear. Lucid, pellucid, translucent are the words. So they felt that they were absolutely like MX. But the difference was that they had never been able to visualize. So they could not visualize how MX is, but they could relate with what is written. For as long as they could remember, they had been aware of this quirk in their psychological nature, while others seemed to have a somewhat visual experience when they thought of an apple, a front door, last holiday, please don't ask me about it, and these folks saw blackness. So maybe when I think about my last holiday, my, you know, the pictures are very fresh in my mind. It's just been 3 days, but... For these people, when you think about your last holiday, all that you can see is blackness. Imagine the kind of life they have. Reading around the topic, I discovered that this quirk is something which is strange, okay? I have a question related to this for you. Strange behavior is known as quirky, okay? You have all these, I'm forgetting the name of the brand that gives you, many brands actually that give you quirky products, okay? Different, strange, had been commented on before. Francis Galton, the first psychologist to measure the vividness of visual imagery, recognized in the 1880s that a small number of those whom he approached lacked imagery entirely. Their powers of visualization were zero. So this guy, psychologist, discovered more people who had zero's visualization power. Oddly, this intriguing observation had lain in the long grass since. What do you mean by lain in the long grass since? Basically, the original idiom is to kick in the long grass. So when you kick something in the long grass, you delay talking about it, usually because you want people to forget about it. Maybe a protest that's going on or anything that the authorities are trying to, take your attention away from. They will stop talking about it for a while so that you forget. It gets delayed and then it's over. Okay, so this is known as kicking in the long grass. One reason might have been that it lacked a convenient name. So ye kyun chala gaya long grass mein? Kyun iske upar zyada research nahi hui, baatein nahi hui, charcha nahi hui? तो इसका एक रीज़न हो सकता है कि इसका एक अच्छा सा कन्वीनियंस सा नाम नहीं था. तो चलो आओ नामकरण करते हैं. सो व्हेन माय कॉलीग्स एंड आई केम टू डिस्क्राइब इन द रिसर्च लिटरेचर द 21 इंडिविजुअल्स हुड मेड कॉन्टैक्ट विद अस, वी डिसाइडेड टू कॉइन वन. इन्होंने कहा चलो लेट्स कीप अ नेम. एट द सजेशन ऑफ माई क्लासिसिस्ट फ्रेंड, आई टीच यू क्लासिसिज्म इन फिलोसफी, बट राइट नाउ क्लासिसिज्म इन शॉर्ट इज अ पर्सन हु इज वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ ग्रीक आर्ट, लिटरेचर, म्यूजिक एट्सेट्रा, ग्रीक और रोमन. ओके, सच अ पर्सन इज नोन एज अ क्लासिसिस्ट. So he had a classicist friend, Michel. He said that Aristotle used the term fantasia. I'll teach you Aristotle in the ongoing RC course. So fantasia is basically imagination. Okay. So Aristotle ne ye word use kara tha, ye Greek word hai. तो उसने बोला कि भाई फैंटेसिया का मतलब है इमेजिनेशन यानी माइंड्स आई। हम एक काम करते हैं, हम प्रीफिक्स लगाते हैं, रूट वर्ड लगाते हैं ए जिसका मतलब है विदाउट, और ए फैंटेसिया नाम रख देते हैं। कंजेनाइटल मीन्स बाय बर्थ, ओके। सो इन द केस ऑफ एम एक्स इट वॉज नॉट कंजेनाइटल बिकॉज इट हैपेंड ड्यू टू अ हार्ट सर्जरी, बट इन मोस्ट पीपल इट इज कंजेनाइटल, इट्स विद यू सिंस योर बर्थ। 5 years on, I have heard from around 14,000 people with unusual mental imagery capacities, most of them at the aphantastic end of the spectrum. So on one end of the spectrum, you have people that see only black, and on one end of the on the spectrum, you have people who are hyperphantastic, who can exactly imagine things, you know. For example, a good dress designer who can look at you and tell you, dude, this will suit you, dude, that this won't suit you, okay. That kind of imagination, exactly imagining how good the reality will be or how bad will it be, is known as hyperphantasia. People who experience imagery as vivid as real seeing, hubahu वैसा ही सोच लेना जैसा real है. Depending on the precise definitions used, aphantasia is estimated to occur in around 3% of the general population and hyperphantasia in around 6% of the population. So, you know, these phenomena are not uncommon or something. So you have 3% who can't imagine and you have 6% who can imagine, like a lot. Taking a little 10-second break here, I am doing RC genre simplified course these days. Yesterday was the first class, the show was houseful as well as a hit. So in case you're already on Plus, please see me tomorrow for the second session at 7:30 p.m. If you're not on Plus, maybe you can now think about subscribing to one. Today I'm starting a new course on all sorts of paragraph-based questions and I'll see you at 7:30. Through questionnaire and face-to-face studies, we have found some consistent associations with these extremes of imagery vividness, helping to assuage. Assuage is kam kar dena, alleviate. I have taught you this word in the vocab course in the root word lev. You can also write soothe. Okay, you can also write placate. You can also write calm. Okay, you can also write pacify or mollify. The worry that they might simply reflect vagaries of introspection. So, vagaries of weather, for example, agar aapne sunao, you know, something which is, changing and you can't really get a hang of it. People with aphantasia are more likely to work in science, maths and IT, while those with hyperphantasia are likely to work in traditionally creative industries, you know. Like I told you, for example, a dress designer. So you will be a really great designer if you have a very great vivid imagination and you can tell people that this will look good on you. Maybe if you're an interior designer, it'll work very well for you because you can exactly imagine how the place will look. Whereas if you are an aphantastic person, maybe you will do very great in science, maths or IT. Aphantasia is associated with difficulty with autobiographical memory because main soch hi nahi sakta how was my last holiday or how was my last meal or how was my friend or family. And with imaginary or future thinking, people with aphantasia also tend to be relatively poor at recognizing faces, which is again very intriguing, as this is a perceptual rather than a representational problem. Because if I can't think about faces, it's going to be slightly weird for me. I'll give you a very simple example. At an academy, the educator cannot see students. But if I take a look at your picture, maybe in your DP or something, I tend to, talk better to you. Because then I can imagine the kind of person I'm speaking to. If you have absolutely no pictures and I've never seen you, then there is some sort of a barrier between us. Because somewhere I am stuck because I can't imagine you while I'm talking to you. But anyway, so this is what happens with them. And they are diagnosed with autism. Autism, the complete name is autistic spectrum disorder. I hope you know what autism is. Several movies have been made, Hollywood and Bollywood. It usually is characterized by lack of speech. And maybe you are stuttering or stammering. Maybe some part of the body is not working properly. This is usually genetic. At above average rates, extremes of imagery tend to cluster in families, hinting at a genetic link or links. So this could be genetic as well. Some people with aphantasia report avisual dreams. Avisual dreams means without visuals. I don't know how that happens. But many dream visually, which suggests wakeful and dreaming imagery depend on somewhat separate processes. So kuch log hain jinke paas bilkul visuals nahi hai. There are some people who can dream visually. So this brings us to the conclusion that wakeful and dreaming imagery depend on separate processes. Wakeful is when you are obviously awake, wide awake, and dreaming imagery is while you are dreaming and then you see images. Some lack imagery in any of the senses, which means no mind's ear or mind's nose. What is a mind's ear? If you're a friends person, can you listen to Janice right now? Yes, oh my god. In Janice's tone, that's your mind's ear. Mind's nose, think about your favorite smell. Petrichor, I taught you on Instagram. वनिला वन ऑफ माई फेवरेट स्मेल्स, सिनेमन ओके, लैवेंडर. सो दिस इज योर माइंड्स नोज. इफ यू कैन थिंक अबाउट द स्मेल एंड फील गुड और बैड अबाउट इट, दिस इज योर माइंड्स नोज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वाइल अदर्स हैव विविड इमेजरी इन एटलीस्ट वन अदर सेंस, इन शॉर्ट ए फैंटेसिया इज ऑलमोस्ट सर्टनली मोर देन वन थिंग. सो देर आर पीपल हु कैन नॉट स्मेल, हु कैन नॉट थिंक ऑफ sounds and who cannot think about images, and there are people who can do one out of the three or two out of three or three out of three, all sorts of people. You might be feeling that on the whole people with aphantasia have a raw deal. Have a raw deal basically means when justice has not been done to you, when something unfair has happened to you. Unfair, okay, unjust and unfair treatment. But while it has some drawbacks, there are advantages too. So theek hai, life thodi unfair ho sakti hai, but kuch advantages bhi hai. Kya advantages hain? Lack of distraction by emotional imagery might allow people with phantasia to be present in ways that some of us might be jealous of. Envy is jealous. अगर आप कुछ भी और नहीं सोच सकते हैं, अगर आप कैट का आरसी पढ़ते पढ़ते सब्यसाची लहंगा नहीं खरीद सकते, तो इसका मतलब when you are reading an RC, you are completely reading an RC. Now I am jealous of a person who can read and study without any lack of concentration, without any distraction. Aren't you jealous of the person like that? So this is what the author is saying, that somebody who cannot imagine much, somebody who cannot see pictures in his mind is lucky, because he will be 100% present where he is, maybe like a saint. It is abundantly clear that aphantasia is compatible with high achievement, so another advantage. Craig Venter, who led the first draft sequences of the human genome, great scientist. Ed Catmull, who is the past president of Disney, recent recipient of the Turing Prize for his work on computer-generated animation, these are his achievements. Blake Ross, who is a co-creator of Mozilla Firefox. Oliver Sacks, who's a neurological author, they all have declared their aphantasia. So all of these people have this issue of aphantasia, and yet they are such high achievers. So maybe the two are correlated. When I first encountered people lacking visual imagery in some numbers, I was fascinated by this invisible variation in human experience. I wondered how to make sense of it. My first pass was that it probably reflected an extreme form of the old distinction between verbalizers and visualizers, bolne wale aur sochne wale. I assume that people lacking imagery would be more dependent on language and generally less interested in the visual world than those with vivid imagery. Now, I have a hint for you here. The tone of the author is going to change, as in the topic is going to slightly shift. You need to observe such shifts when you are reading an RC passage. This will help you solve the questions, and when we do the question today, this will help you mark your answer. My colleagues in our Eyes Mind project at the University of Exeter, two historians, philosopher, artists, neuroscientists broadly agreed. The finding that aphantasia predisposes people, predisposes is kisi cheez ke prati rujhan hona, to have an interest or liking or an inclination towards something. To work in scientific rather than creative traits seem to bear out this assumption. Bear out is usually used in the sense of support. It's a phrasal verb, okay? So humne assume kara tha ki bhai, people who are aphantasia, they will want to work in scientific teams rather than creative trades, okay? But when we found out things, maybe our assumption was supported slightly, but not completely. Imagine our puzzled surprise then, as aphantastic visual artists got in touch in growing numbers, about 150 so far, alongside a smattering of actors, authors and architects. Smattering is like a tiny amount, okay? Very few. So kehte hai ki humne socha tha ki aphantastic people cannot be creative. But then there were 150 people who got in touch with us, and some of them were actors, authors and architects. Most of them are creative people. Why would you want to depict a world you can't imagine? So, मैं सोच नहीं सकता, मैं visuals नहीं देख सकता, लेकिन मैं एक ऐसी दुनिया depict कर रहा हूँ जो मैं imagine नहीं कर सकता. How can you be an actor like that? Or how can you be a architect? How can you be an architect like that? How can artists create without any imagery to guide their creation? I realized belatedly after hearing from these people that aphantasia might sometimes increase rather than reduce interest in the visual world. तो ये लोग जो सोच रहे थे, ये उसका contradiction है. People with aphantasia see perfectly well, and they have an eye for beauty. They have that parkhi nazar for khoobsurti that all of you have. In fact, deprived of the ability to contemplate the look of things in their mind's eye, their visual attention to the here and now might be heightened. अभी एकदम opposite. कि भाई आपके पास एबिलिटी नहीं है, यू डोंट हैव द कैपेसिटी और द एबिलिटी टू थिंक कंटेम्पलेट द लुक ऑफ थिंग्स इन देयर माइंड्स आई. सो आई कांट इमेजिन एन एप्पल राइट नाउ, सो माय विजुअल अटेंशन व्हेन आई लुक एट एन एप्पल इज गोइंग टू बी हायर देन अ पर्सन हु कैन इमेजिन एन एप्पल. सो मे बी आई विल लुक एट ऑल दोज येलो एंड ग्रीन स्ट्रोक्स एंड द स्टॉक बॉटम और द कैलिक्स एट द टॉप एंड एवरीथिंग. सो दिस इज हाइटेंड बिकॉज आई नो आई कांट इमेजिन दिस लेटर. ये एप्पल ही सब कुछ है, इसको देख कर ही कुछ किया जा सकता है. इसीलिए मेरी अटेंशन पेइंग कैपेसिटी इज बेटर देन द अदर्स इफ आई एम ए फैंटास्टिक एंड लैकिंग अ माइंड्स आई माइट ऑल्सो इंक्रीज द मोटिवेशन टू रिप्रेजेंट द विजुअल आर्टिस्टिकली एज माई कॉलीग pointed out to me, if you're a fantastic, you want to know what something looks like, one solution is to draw it. So if I'm supposed to look at this mouse because I know that I can never see this mouse again, or maybe I can't imagine it, then I will look at every intricacy, at the logo that is drawn at the bottom, and you know, completely look at it. And then a good solution is that I should draw it out. So when I draw it out, it'll probably stay with me because I can't think about it later when it is not with me on my table. This meshed with the meshed means combined or wired with the report from many of our study participants that they use photography extensively to capture appearances that they would otherwise be unable to retrieve. Photography becomes very important. Why do we capture pictures? So if I went to Kashmir, I took 1,000 pictures. Why? Because I'm never going to Kashmir again, right? So if I know that I cannot imagine the tulips I saw in the tulip garden, I will take 100 pictures because I cannot think about a tulip right now. So this is exactly what's written. As Sherry Bakes, a Canadian artist who unusually had lost imagery following a stroke at the age of 29, told us, the paintings have become the picture inside that I cannot see. So ye ek chashmadeed gawah ka bayan hai ki jo main dekh nahi sakta, meri paintings wo kehti hain. After the stroke, I taught myself to paint even before I could walk or speak because it was the only thing I could really do. So after the stroke, she taught herself how to paint because she found it was important. Increasingly struck by the accounts we were receiving in 2019, we mounted an exhibition of work by aphantastic and hyperphantastic artists in Glasgow and then at the Royal Fala Fala. The details are not important. I would challenge any visitor to diagnose which category each artist belonged to. उन्होंने एक exhibition लगाई और challenge करा visitor को कि बताओ ये किस तरीके का artist है. Artists with aphantasia produce works ranging from the photorealist to the abstract. Abstract painters are, you know, painters that draw things that do not have concrete shapes. Okay. And photorealists are people who look at photographs and then make an art form out of it, trying to give it a look of a photograph or making it as close to reality as possible. Conjuring vivid detail, you know, आवाहन करना lively details का, as well as suggestive ambiguity, और जो बची हुई ambiguity है उसका भी, but their accounts of their artistic process were distinctive. So the account, the way they work, the process that they adopt is very distinctive. The point of departure for the aphantastic artist's work is not a visual image, but a feeling, an emotion, a desire, or an energy, thoughts and ideas, a sense of spatial arrangement. Spatial comes from the word space, okay? So dimensions and corners and geometry and stuff, spatial arrangement. Some then make use of existing materials through collages, reworkings of famous paintings. Some people rely on drawing, archives of images, photos, etc., etc. And then there is a third group, intriguingly to the author, describes developing work on the page or canvas as a kind of externalized imagination, allowing them to push and engage with the appearing image, sometimes with a thrilling sense of stepping out into the unknown. So there are also abstract painters who don't look at a photograph, who don't look at an archive, who don't look at somebody else's painting and just draw without thinking and just explore into the unknown and give it a very externalized form. Keeping this paragraph a little short, this just has, you know, a lot of examples. So Catmull, illustrator, then Glenn Kleen is an animator or from The Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, they lack imagery. Then again, you're talking about the movie Frozen here. I really like this line that I have highlighted here, so I'll read it. I have seen a clip of Kane drawing that shows him peering. Peering is jhankna. Intently is intentionally. Atroprenumerary, which is basic. Indecipherable, jise aap decipher nahi kar sakte, jise aap samaj nahi sakte. Scribble is kuch bhi scribble karna, jiska koi sense nahi hai. Hunting for the cues that will help him to conjure a vivid drawing from the page. To koi vyakti jo nahi soch sakta, a person who cannot think in images, will be very attentive, like I told you, and when he looks at things, even something which is an indecipherable scribble, things writing that you cannot understand, that you cannot decipher, his way of looking at it will change. Intriguingly, he belongs to a lineage of artists, you know, Khandani artists. His father Bill was a celebrated cartoonist, daughter Claire is the one who worked in the movie Frozen in 2013. Coming to the end of the article, and then we do a few questions. A finding that aphantasia predisposes people to work in the sciences suggests that our initial assumption that it would militate against a career in art was not wholly wrong. But we are immensely complex creatures. The possession of visual imagery is one small piece in the huge jigsaw of cognition. There are many ways to represent things in their absence besides a sensory image, language, for example, and as our exhibition illustrated art. Our work with A Fantastic Creatives drives home another broad conclusion. We should not confuse visualization with imagination, the far broader capacity to represent, reshape, and reconceive things in their absence. Now, let's understand this a little because this is the conclusion. He says, हमारी ये जो फाइंडिंग थी, what we found out through our research, कि aphantasia वाला people are inclined towards working, you know, in sciences and against art because they cannot imagine, so they will be against art. It was not wholly wrong. So it was not completely wrong, partially right, partially wrong. We are immensely complex and we work on the basis of language. We work on other sensory images. And of course, we can come to a conclusion that we should not confuse visualization with imagination. Now, generally, visualization and imagination are synonyms. But here in this context, visualization comes from the word visual. So maybe the person cannot literally visualize, but they do have a sense of imagination, which is a far broader capacity, which will help you represent something, reshape something or reconceive it if the thing is absent. Agar wo aapke saamne nahi hai, to aap usse soch sakte hain, samajh sakte hain. As the examples of these are concerned, a fantasy is not a bar to an imaginative life. It does not stop you. If reading this, you come to the conclusion that you too might lack imagery or you have it in spades, I have a question here for you. Don't hesitate to contact me at this email ID as we still have much to learn. If you are a person like this, this is the email ID for you. Also, please read this last sentence so that you can solve the question. I'll read it out again. If reading this, you come to the conclusion that you too might lack imagery or have it in spades. Okay, lack imagery or conjunction notice karo, have it in spades. Don't hesitate to contact me. Okay, let's go to the questions. Before we do the questions, I'm taking live CAT classes at Unacademy Plus, and this is my code that you could use to get yourself a discount, Karishma Live. Tomorrow, I have a free class for anyone and everyone who's interested on the Unacademy app or website at 12:30 noon. You just use my code and the class is free to attend. Okay. Let's do the questions. I want to see your answers. Yes, Shalini, you can continue if you want or you can watch the recording. Let's do the first question. Which word can be used to characterize the tone of the author? Analytical, sympathetic, sardonic, or discursive? I'm waiting for your answers. And because there is a 15-second gap between you and me, you can also do more than one question and write your answers, but number your answers so that I know what are you saying. ओके बॉबी रेड कलर दिख नहीं रहा, ठीक है चेंज कर देंगे अगली बार से. निकिता एंड रिचा, रिया, सात्विक ए, मेघना ए, शाहबाज ए, सृष्टि ओवर एक्साइटेड ट्रिपल ए, एवरीबडी इज सेइंग ए. ओके सो आई थिंक सिंपैथेटिक इज डेफिनेटली आउट, द ऑथर इज नॉट सिंपथाइजिंग विद पीपल हु हैव ए फैंटेसिया. सार्डोनिक इज डेफिनेटली रॉन्ग, आई हैव टॉट यू इन द आरसी टोन्स क्लास, इट्स नॉट सिनिकल और मॉकिंग. Analytical and discursive bachta, it's an analysis of aphantasia, art, imagination, creation, hyperphantasia and everything. So this is the correct answer. Discursive is when you are digressing from one part to the other, right? Also, I'm sorry that I think the text of the question is not completely visible to you. It's getting hidden behind my picture. I didn't realize that. Anyway, question number two. Choose the most appropriate title for the passage. Main idea question, theme question. Neeraj says B. Nikita also says B. Sushri B. Options are similar. You need to be careful. Does the world look dark or the mind looks dark? Does the world look dark or the mind looks dark? That will help you rule out two options. The world is not dark because you're not blind. We're not talking about blind people here. Okay, we're not talking about the visual impaired. We are also not talking about depression or hopelessness where the world looks dark. The mind is dark is certainly better. So we will rule out two options here. Okay, then we are left with B and D. This says art becomes a hobby. Art's not becoming a hobby for people who are aphantastic. In fact, there are people who are inclined towards IT, maths and science. You remember that line? Art is a thrilling way to see. You know, you observe and then you become photorealists and abstract painters and blah, blah, blah. So this is the best answer. This is the best title. ध्रुव डोंट वरी, ध्रुव वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद अ न्यू कोर्स टुडे, 7:30 आ जाओ क्लास में, वहाँ बात करते हैं क्या पढ़ना है, कैसे पढ़ना है एंड ऑल दैट स्टफ. ओके, व्हाट अबाउट द थर्ड वन? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय हैव इट इन स्पेड्स? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय हैव इट इन स्पेड्स? इट्स एन ईडियम. याद है पीछे कंजंक्शन लिखा था और, ठीक, और उसके पहले क्या लिखा था? लैक. लैक मतलब कमी है, और यानी कॉन्ट्रास्ट है, तो उसके आगे क्या आएगा? गेस कर सकते हैं. यू वॉन्ट मी टू गो बैक? या आइदर यू लैक इमेजरी और यू हैव इट इन स्पेड्स. वॉट डज दैट मीन? फाइंड द इम्प्लाइड मीनिंग, भावार्थ बताओ. वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड, शाबाश कृति. तो या तो नहीं है ए फैंटेसी को, या बहुत सारा है हाइपर. सो टू हैव इन एक्सट्रीम्स. ओके, शी हैज हेल्थ इशूज इन स्पेड्स, एक्सट्रीम्स, बहुत सारा. ओके, करेक्ट, करेक्ट निकिता, करेक्ट कृति, वेरी गुड. सो दिस इज हाउ यू शुड बी एबल टू गेस इन द एग्जाम, बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट हैव द डिक्शनरी और गूगल और मी विद यू. ओके, लेट्स डू द लास्ट वन. फोर सिनोनिम्स ऑफ वेगरीज, वेरी क्विकली. फोर सिनोनिम्स ऑफ वेगरीज, वेरी क्विकली. इन लार्ज क्वांटिटी? नो नो नो, वो तो पिछला वाला था. मोस्ट ऑफ यू गिवन द राइट आंसर फॉर हैव इट इन स्पेड्स. एक्सट्रीम इनफ? नो. सो बेसिकली वेगरीज इज अनएक्सपेक्टेड बिहेवियर. आई टॉट यू द वर्ड क्वर्क टूडे. ओके, सो लेट्स राइट दिस डाउन. अनएक्सपेक्टेड बिहेवियर, क्वर्क इज अ गुड सिनोनिम, एक्सेंट्रिसिटी इज अ गुड सिनोनिम. यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट पिक्यूलियर, पिक्यूलियर बिहेवियर, पिक्यूलियरिटी. यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट ऑडिटी. ओके, यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट अ गुड वर्ड इडियोसिंक्रेसी. आई हैव टॉट यू दिस आई गेस. You know, some people will always sit in the front seat of the car. It's a quirky behavior. Why can't you sit at the back? Okay, so these are all synonyms. So vagaries of weather, I gave you the example. Strange, it changes and we don't know what to do. Peculiarity is correct. Unpredictability is also okay. Dull, theek nahi hai. Quirky is okay. Oddity is okay. Mercurial chalega Mars. Mercurial is more about whimsical, you know, changing now and then. So, फार है बट या एक्सेप्टेबल. सो योर असाइनमेंट फॉर द डे इज, दिस इज ऑब्वियसली द टाइटल ऑफ द आर्टिकल, यू गेस्ड इट राइट, यू रीड इट फ्रॉम psyche.co अगेन इफ यू विश. योर होमवर्क इज टू रीड मोर सच नॉन फिक्शन आर्टिकल्स. अ फ्यू अनाउंसमेंट्स, वी विल हैव आवर नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑन मंडे विच इज 19th. प्लीज पार्टिसिपेट ऑन संडे इन द अनअकैडमी कॉम्बैट एंड यू मे गेट अ स्कॉलरशिप. यूज दिस कोड टू जॉइन द टेस्ट. These are the rates, so there has been a price hike. Okay, so use my code Karishma Live to get yourself a discount. These are the various batches that are starting new. You can subscribe to Iconic instead of Plus. Use Ask a Doubt feature on Unacademy. And that's all for today. I hope the session was fruitful and you enjoyed it. If yes, then please share it with your friends so that they can also make use of it. We will continue with another article and do more such articles. You're free to send in your suggestions here in the comment section or on Telegram. Thank you and have a great day. I will see you in the 7:30 class. Take care.